So let's start with today's lecture. That is, we have already completed two modules. And now we are going to start with our module number three. Right? So kindly check the heading of this particular module. Module number three is all about creating hashes. We have introduced, we have seen what exactly is a hash function in our previous, in our very first chapter. It was just an introduction, right? So we are going to focus on that. What is a hash? What is the use of a hash function? Why do we go for a hash function? What is avalanche effect? Fine, these are all those things we are going to learn in this module, module number three. It's a short module. According to a syllabus, it consists of six lectures. I will see how many lectures we are going to need to complete this. But according to syllabus, it is approximately going to take six lectures to complete this module. So this is our first lecture of this module, module number three. The very first topic is hash. Then we are going to see what are the applications of hashes, how we can make use of hash functions to secure our data, what is the goal of security which is being satisfied by the hashes, and then we will see the applications of hash functions. The very first and very popular application is called as message digest. We are going to look at it, what exactly is a message digest, followed by digital certificates. These are very important concepts from your subject point of view. So first of all, we'll see what is a hash, what is a hash function, properties of a hash function. Then we will see what is a message digest. That is, these are the applications of hash functions. Am I clear? So just have a look at the screen. I have written a very simple sort of a definition for a hash. Just have a look. What exactly is a hash function? You can call it a hash function or a hash. First, read this definition and then try to correlate this with one of your goals of security. Let me know which goal of security is satisfied using this particular concept, that is hash. A hash function or a hash is basically a variable h which accepts a variable in the block. It simply means your plain text could be of any size. Fine. Whatever be the size of the plain text, you are generally going to produce a fixed size hash value, which is nothing but a function of the message m. Am I clear? Is it clear from the definition? It's very simple. You are given a plain text m. You can say that this plain text is nothing but the message m, right? And when you feed this message m into the hash function, simply writing function over here, this is nothing but h of m, you will get something as the result. And this something or this output is nothing but the hash value. Am I clear? So the message m could be of variable length, it could be of 100 bytes, 200 bytes, 1000 bytes, whatever it may be. But you will get a fixed size output, which is what we call as a hash function. Am I clear? Any confusions, any doubts so far? Yes, do let me know if you're having any confusions so far. It's clear. Okay. Now, can you tell me what is the main use of hash function? Any one of you can let me know. How can we make use of hashes? Yes, any one of you can let me know the answer. Hashing passwords, okay. What else? Any more answers? Let me check the chat box. B division, kindly let me know answers. A division, you also. I'm getting answers as passwords, okay, hashing passwords. Apart from that, anything else? Yes. Message, obviously we are going to hash a message. But what is the significance? Why do we hash? Yes, kindly let me know. Okay, before that, kindly let me know what are the various three goals of security. Just revise once again, what were the three goals of security? And based upon that, we will come to a conclusion. Just come on, let me know. Correct. Confidentiality, integrity, and availability were the three things or the three goals of security, out of which integrity is maintained if we make use of hash. Yes or no? We had seen in the very first lecture that if we want to make sure whether our data has got tampered with or our data has got changed anyhow during the communication, we can come to know with the help of hashing, yes or no, with the help of a simple integrity check. Do you recollect avalanche effect we had seen in the very first module itself? Can any one of you let me know what exactly is avalanche effect? Yes, Jyoti, correct. Any one of you? Yeah, my mic got disconnected, so I have to reload the page. One second. I will just present my screen once again. Can you please write the answers once again, because I had to reload my page, so all the answers are gone now. Kindly let me know the answers once again in the chat box. Harsh is saying if input changes slightly, output changes. Okay. Basically, for a slight change in the input, there is a huge change in the output. Correct. What else? Small change in plain text causes large change in cipher text. Correct. This is what we call as avalanche effect. I had given you a question also, if you remember, and I had asked you to actually calculate the percentage change. I guess it came out to be in excess of 90%, 80%, if I'm not wrong. Jyoti is saying 93% change. Okay, Jimmy is saying number of bits. Basically, the number of bits depend. The number of bits can keep on changing. Okay, but in general terms, I can say that for very small change in the input, there will be a large change in the output. That is what we call as the avalanche effect. Clear? Any confusions, do let me know. Fine, can we move ahead? Kindly give me an acknowledgement so that I can move ahead with the topic. It's B division. Okay, fine. So let me continue with the topic for the day, which is what we call as hashing. I hope you got the basic idea of what exactly the hash function. Now let me move ahead. We can say that a good hash function, I'm just reading the sentence and then I will come back to the actual definition. A good hash function has the property that the results of applying the function to a large set of inputs will produce outputs that are evenly distributed and apparently random. What it means is, if you apply a good hash function, we are talking about a good hash function over here. That is, which hash function is termed as a good hash function. So basically, a good hash function has the property, or it should possess the property, that if we apply that hash function to a large set of inputs, it should produce outputs that are evenly distributed and which should appear to be random. For example, the hash for this word and the hash for this word, they should not be equal, or we can say that they should not be remotely equal to each other. There should be a lot of difference in the hash of this five-letter word and this five-letter word. Am I clear? So the length of the message has nothing to do with the hash generated. Similarly, if I say that hello is a word, apple is a word, if I take hash of hello and if I take hash of apple, both of the hash values should be strikingly different. Am I clear? It should be विजिबली डिफरेंट ऑल्सो. नेकेड आई से भी वो डिफरेंट दिखना चाहिए. ऐसा नहीं है कि हम उसका हैश निकाले, कंप्यूटर पे डाले, तभी हमें उसका डिफरेंस समझे. इफ वी चेक द हैश वैल्यूज ऑफ बोथ दीज फंक्शन, बोथ दीज वर्ड्स, दैट इज हेलो एंड एप्पल, देन ऑल्सो वी शुड स्ट्राइकिंगली मेक अ डिफरेंस दैट दोनों का हैश बहुत डिफरेंट है, आपस में बहुत डिफरेंट है. वो होना चाहिए. दे शुड अपियर रैंडमली एंड दे शुड बी इवनली डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड. एम आई क्लियर? एम आई मेकिंग सेंस? डू लेट मी नो. Although both are five-letter words, but still, whatever hash we generate out of it, they should be very much different from each other. Is it clear? Yes, come on, let me know. A division, B division. Fine. Okay. So let's move ahead. So this is what I was talking about, a good hash function. Next up, in general terms, the principal objective of a hash function is data integrity that we have already seen. That is, if there is a slight change in the input during the communication of that message from Alice's workstation to Bob's workstation, suppose there is Alice, there is Bob, this is the communication path. For example, this is the internet. So if the message hello is being sent using this communication path, it should be received as hello only. It should not be received as apple or whatever it may be. Fine. If there is a change of even a single bit during the communication process, then it will lead to a change in the hash value also. That is what we call as the avalanche effect. We have seen it on numerous occasions, right? So what we say is the principal objective of hash function is data integrity. That is, a change to any bit or bits in the message M will result in a change, huge change in the hash code. Am I clear? Yes. Simple enough. Okay. So let's move ahead with the next slide. Okay. So this was all about hashes and hash functions. Now, what are the various kinds of hash functions? What is the application of hash in terms of security? Integrity is a totally different thing. Integrity के लिए तो use होने ही वाला है, no issues. कि आपने data send किया, data receive हुआ कि नहीं, data में कितना change हुआ, उसके लिए हम लोग hash use कर ही सकते हैं. But apart from that, the hashes which are used for security applications are what we call as cryptographic hash functions. So in the exam or in the Viva, a question may be asked, what is the difference between a hash function and a cryptographic hash function? So this should be the difference you should see. That is, the kind of hash functions which are needed for security applications specifically are referred to as cryptographic hash functions. Am I clear? Otherwise, hash ka use to har jagah hota hai, hashing and indexing, you must have studied, right? Am I clear? But whenever we make use of the hash functions in terms of application security or security applications, that is what we call as a cryptographic hash function. Am I clear? Kindly let me know. Yes, come on, let me know in the chat box. If this concept is clear or not. What is a hash function and what is a cryptographic hash function? Fine? Okay. So let's move ahead with the next topic. Next definition, in fact. So basically, what are the significance of a cryptographic hash functions? What are the various requirements of a cryptographic hash function? Just have a look at this particular slide on your screen. A cryptographic hash function is an algorithm for which it is computationally infeasible to find. There are two things or two properties of a cryptographic hash function. I'm going to discuss each one of these one by one in detail. First of all, let me know, is my screen visible or you're having any buffering issues, because I have turned on my camera today. So kindly let me know if there is any network lag from my side. Okay, it's proper. Fine. Okay, thank you. So yeah, just coming back to the topic, a cryptographic hash function is an algorithm for which it is computationally infeasible to find. There are two things which should be satisfied. Let's discuss the first one. A data object, first of all, let me see. A cryptographic hash function is an algorithm for which it should be, or it is computationally infeasible to find either a data object that maps to a pre-specified hash result. What does it mean is, just read it once and let me know what is your understanding out of this definition. A cryptographic hash function is an algorithm for which it is computationally infeasible. It simply means, you can say, virtually impossible. I'm simply writing a line over here. Virtually impossible. Okay. So basically, a cryptographic hash function is an algorithm for which it is virtually impossible to find, first one, a data object that maps to a pre-specified hash result. So for example, if I am having a table where there is a word list, I can say word list, and over here there's a hash list. Fine. So if I am having a word, again, I'm taking the same word apple, and there is a hash, for example, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, whatever is the hash. Similarly, there is a word hello, and it will be having a hash 3, 2, 5, 4, 7, so and so. So we should not have another word, for example, lemon. We should not have another word which could have the same hash value present in the table. Am I making sense? Yes or no? Just have a look at this diagram and let me know. Just read this definition once again. A cryptographic hash function is an algorithm for which it is computationally infeasible or virtually impossible to find either a data object that maps to a pre-specified hash result. So in the table, if I'm having a hash, for example, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, which is corresponding to Apple, I should not have, or I cannot have, the hash of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 for any other word, in this case, lemon. Am I clear? Yes or no? kindly check this slide, kindly check this diagram, the table, and let me know if it is clear or not. Yes, A division. Harsh, Jay, Jimit, Deep, Parth, Jyoti. Yeah, I'm repeating once again. Just have a look at this table. This is an example given. We are having a word list and we are having the hashes corresponding to those words. Fine. Let me zoom it up if needed. Fine. So what we are having over here is there's a word list and there's the hash corresponding to it. So in the table, if I'm having the word apple and this is the hash for the word apple, similarly, there's a word hello and this is the hash for the word hello. So I cannot have one more word which corresponds to the same hash value as that of apple. Is it clear? Yes or no? So can we have the word lemon in the word list or not? This is what I'm asking. No. Clear? Why? Because it should be computationally infeasible to have another data object or another data word which has the same hash value as any other data word. Clear? This is what we call as the one-way function. So basically, one-way function is like you're having a plain text, you're computing the hash of it, but from the hash, you cannot compute the plain text back. Obviously, it is like encryption and decryption, but over here, in this case, if you're having the plain text, you can create a hash out of it. Simply pass the plain text into the algorithm, the hashing algorithm, and you will get the output. That is, the input is your plain text, output is your hash. But the reverse is not possible. For example, if you are having the hash, you cannot generate the text back. For that, you obviously need the table also. So I'm talking it from the attacker's point of view. If the attacker has got access to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, the attacker won't be able to calculate apple out of it. Am I clear? This is what we call as the one-way function. Is it clear? So again, I'm repeating, you can create the hash from the plain text, but you can't create the plain text from the hash. This is what we call as the one-way function. Am I clear? Yes or no? Kindly let me know. Clear? What about B division? Obviously, you might be asking questions that, sir, encryption ke time pe bhi wahi hota hai. We should have the key. Otherwise, decrypt kaise karenge? The same thing happens over here. If you are willing to decrypt it, aapko online kaafi sare hash milenge, hash on generators milenge. What they do is they have their own table. Once you create the hash of a plain text, for example, aapne apple dala, apple ka aapko kuch ek hash milega, they store it in their table. Samjha? Then what they will do is they will simply fire a lookup. Ek lookup karenge, search karenge table mein. जिसका भी हैश 1234 होगा उसका करेस्पॉन्डिंग वैल्यू एप्पल विल बी शोन टू यू एज द रिवर्स ऑफ द हैशिंग प्रोसेस बट अटैकर के पास वो टेबल नहीं होता है. एम आई मेकिंग सेंस? यस और नो? काइंडली लेट मी नो. यस और नो? फाइन. बिकॉज द अटैकर डजंट हैव द एंटायर वर्ड लिस्ट विद हिम. अटैकर विल टू कीप ऑन ट्राइंग अटैकर विल हैव टू कीप ऑन ट्राइंग द ब्रूट फोर्स एल्गोरिथम्स जो कि बहुत ज्यादा टाइम कंज्यूमिंग है. दैट इज व्हाई इट इज कॉल्ड एज वर्चुअली इम्पॉसिबल. आई हैव नॉट मेंशन्ड एनीवेयर दैट इट इज इम्पॉसिबल. इट इज वर्चुअली मतलब मोस्ट लाइकली 99% इम्पॉसिबल. फाइन. और अदरवाइज द अटैकर विल हैव टू हैव विल नीड अ लॉट ऑफ पेशेंस एंड अ वेरी हाई कंप्यूटिंग पावर सिस्टम. राइट. फाइन. कैन वी मूव अहेड? सो दिस वॉज द वेरी फर्स्ट कंडीशन. दैट इज अ क्रिप्टोग्राफिक हैश फंक्शन इज एन एल्गोरिथम for which it is virtually impossible or computationally infeasible to find a data object that maps to a pre-specified hash result. Next is the second condition, that is two data objects that map to the same hash result. Again, the similar kind of thing. Basically, if I want to sum it up, I have actually given an example which sums up both the values, both the conditions. One-way function is you can have the hash from the plain text, but you can't have the plain text from the hash. Fine. And second one is no two words can have the same hash. Maine common example mein dono explain kar diya aapko. I'm writing it over here. Can have same hash. If it happens, then that is what we call as a collision. But a hash is a collision free property. That is, a hash has a collision free property. That is, no two words can have the same hash value. Is it clear now? Kindly have a look at the screen. I have written some points over there on top of these conditions. The first property is a data object that maps to a pre-specified hash result. That is the one-way property. That is, you can get the hash from the plaintext, but you can't get the plaintext from the hash. This is the first property. And second one, we have already discussed that no two words can have the same hash. Is it clear? Can we move ahead? Yes, kindly let me know. B division, A division. Okay, fine. Okay, so because of these characteristics, we can say that hash functions are often used to determine whether or not the data has changed or not. Am I clear? This is how we can make sure that the integrity of the data is maintained. So we have so far seen what is a hash, what is a hash function, followed by the properties of a good hash value or a hash function, then the cryptographic hash function, and what are the direct properties of a cryptographic hash function. Fine. So let's move ahead with this explanation or this simulation. As you can see on your screens, this is basically like a juicer. You must have seen sugarcane juice or any other citric fruit juices, apples, oranges ke juice nikalte hai, waisa machine hai, theek hai? So you put the fruits from one end and you will get the juice from the other end, right? So over here what we are doing, we are simply, for example, mujhe orange juice peena hai. So I want it at my home. Because juicer hai, I will put the oranges and get the juice from the other end. So what exactly happens is, I have few glasses which are of equal size. Just imagine these are equal size glasses. Okay, so the volume of each of these glasses have to be same. So what happens is, if I prepare the juice, the level of these glasses, the maximum which these glasses can hold, will be equal. Yes or no? And I'm just giving you very layman sort of examples so as to make the concept clear. Fine. So basically what I'm trying to say is, I'm having I'm having glasses which are having a maximum capacity. So if I want fresh juice, orange juice, what I will do is, I will put the oranges from one end and I will get the juice from the other end, right? So at the max, the glass should be able to hold a maximum amount, maximum volume. If I try to pour any little bit of juice on top of it, it will obviously overflow. Yes or no? Simple. Yahan tak samjha sabko? If you are having any issues so far, kindly let me know. I'm trying to give lamest possible examples to make this thing clear. Yes, come on, A division, B division, kindly give me acknowledgement so that I can move ahead. Okay, what about B? Okay, fine. So just imagine the size, or we can say the amount of juice in all of these glasses has to be equal. It cannot be different because the glasses are same, the maximum capacity are same. So obviously these will be fixed sized hashes. Yes or no? Whatever number of apples, oranges, whatever fruits I have, I can put 10 fruits, I can put 5 fruits, I can put 7 fruits. Whatever number of fruits I put, the amount of juice that can be accommodated in a glass will not change. It has to be of the same dimension only. Yes or no? So I can say that whatever be the size of the input, the output will always remain constant. In this case, the output is nothing but the amount of juice that particular glass can hold at the max. That is what is the size of the message digest, or I can say that is what is the size of the hash output. Am I clear? Yes or no? Yes, A division. You want any more explanations on this? Obviously, I will give you technical explanations. Don't worry. Exam mein aisa juice woos likhe mata na, marks nahi milega. So I'm just giving you some examples. Fine. Clear. Okay. Okay, so now let me explain what exactly happens technically. So before going there, for example, last glass, जो आपका last glass बचा है, fine. Suppose the last glass है, that cannot be filled because we are running out of fruits. So what is the possible option? And I want it to be, I want all the glasses to be of equal size. What are the options available in front of you? And I have run out of oranges. So what I can do? False character. Yeah, correct. That is what we call as padding, right? If you remember. Yes, come on. Now I expect answers from you. We have already seen two tests on chapters, chapter 1 and 2. Traffic padding, if you remember. Yes or no? B division, I'm not getting answers from you today. Yes? Remember traffic padding or characters at the end of the gate, yes or no? Yes. What about others? I'm not getting answers from you people. Kindly reciprocate. I know it's a last, you have to be active. Even we are active for the whole day. Okay, so kindly let me know only answers I'm getting from both the day. What is the reason? I don't know. Achha nahi padha raha ho to bol do. I'm open to feedback. Just come on, let me. Ash, I'm just asking about what exactly is traffic padding. That is what I'm asking. Traffic padding kyun karte hai? If we run out of the data, basically if we run out of the plain text, last wala jo group hai, usko bharne ke liye kuch data lagega na apne ko. To wo kya kahan se aayega? That is what I'm asking. Fine. So in this case, if I run out of oranges, what is the option in front of me? ताकि उसका taste भी ज़्यादा change ना हो. Its taste doesn't change drastically. Yeah, we can put ice. Very good answer. We can put ice, little water, little sugar, or we can, yeah, correct. We can dilute it a little. By putting some ice, yes, correct. That is what I was looking for. We can add some other citric fruits, for example, lemon. Lemon डालेंगे तो taste में इतना ज़्यादा change नहीं होगा, and then we can put some water to dilute it. You are getting the concept, right? I'm not opening a fruit juice center over here. I'm just giving you some examples, right? So what I'm trying to say is कि you have to make sure that the last fragment or the last section, the last part should also be of the same size. So what we do is we add some extra characters, some extra bits. That is what we call as some traffic padding, right? So this is the best example I could have given, non-technical. Fine. So just have a look over here. What is L? What is P? P is nothing but, just have a look. What is P? P is nothing but the padding. And what is L? L is nothing but the length of the bits. So for example, I want to make sure that the total length should be 1024 bits. This is just an example. Okay. So I am running out of some 20 bits. For example, I'm having only 1004 bits and I'm talking about the last section or the last block. Okay. Pehle ke dono blocks bhar chuke hain. Last jo block bacha hai, usme 1024 ki jagah sirf 1004 bits hai. So I'm short by 20 bits, right? So this 20 bit is nothing but the padding bit. Am I clear? So the so jo difference hai 20 bits ka, that is what we call as the padding bit. And this is how a hash is represented. We need to write the message or data block along with the padding, along with the length. So suppose aapka message hai hello, whatever is the message. Along with that, you need to write the number of padding bits you have added. It could be 20, comma, the length. Length is 1024. Is it clear now technically, yes or no? Yahan tak aane ke liye I had to explain all these things. Fine. Come on, let me give you a feedback. Let me know if you understood this topic or not. Yes, B division. I'm not getting answers. Disappointing. Yes. Yeah, Harsh. Salting is basically you're converting a plain password, adding some random digits, and then passing it on to the receiver or wherever you want to send it. We can say salting is an application of hashing, sort of. It is not exactly similar to hashing. Fine, we'll learn about it later. It's not in our syllabus, but I will focus on that also. Fine, got it. Okay, can we move ahead? Do let me know. Okay, fine. Thanks. So this was all about the structure of hashing, how hashes are generated, what is the fixed size hash, etc., etc. Fine, so let's move ahead. Now we are going to start with the applications of cryptographic hash functions. We are not going to cover the entire topic today. It's a lengthier topic. If you want, I will just show you the topics which I have prepared. So it's a lengthy thing, but don't worry, it's all a conceptual thing. One by one. So we won't rush into anything. We have ample amount of lectures to complete this topic, complete this chapter. Fine. And the term test will be from 24, 25, and 26 May, March, if I'm not wrong. Last week of March, 24 to 26 March. Let me check the calendar. Yeah, 24, 25, and 26 March. So by then, we are obviously going to complete this chapter. So, three modules, first three modules for the term test, and it will be descriptive. It won't have any as per the instruction we have received. Am I clear? Kindly let me know. If you're having any doubts, do clear it right now. The term test will be descriptive, totally 20 marks. The format will be made available to you. I guess it will be the same format which we used to follow earlier. 2 marks questions and then 5 marks questions. It clear? Fine. Can we move ahead? Yeah, same duration, 1 hour. पहले भी वही होता था ना. Obviously, we'll get time for uploading. Uploading का time मिलेगा अलग से, but 1 घंटा exam लिखने के लिए. Okay. चलो. So let's start with the applications of cryptographic hash functions. So basically, there are two applications in our cryptographic hash functions. The first one is message authentication, or we can say message digest. There are different names. Message digest and digital certificates. Fine. So let's start with the very first type, which is message authentication. So what exactly is message authentication? Just read it once. Message authentication is a mechanism or service which is used to verify the integrity of a message. This is quite similar to encryption, but it is not exactly same as encryption. How is it different? Just read it once. Message authentication is a mechanism or a service which is used to verify the integrity of a message. Whenever we are talking about hashes, whenever we are talking about message digest, we are simply talking about the integrity goal of security. Am I clear? We are not talking about confidentiality because encryption has already taken care of it, right? We have seen in the first two chapters how we can provide confidentiality to a data by simply encrypting it. Yes or no? Same चीज किया था ना हम लोगों ने. We had made use of keys, public key and private key cryptography. We have seen using those two concepts, we saw that how we can provide confidentiality to our data. Right? Okay. But in this case, we are only going to deal with integrity of the data. Fine. Okay. So कैसे करेंगे? How to just read it once. Message authentication is a mechanism or service which is used to verify the integrity of a message. Now it assures that the data received by the receiver are exactly as the one which was sent by the sender. That is what is the goal of integrity, right? So we can say that with the use of hashing or message authentication, first of all, we can ensure that the data is not changed at all. And second, we can also make sure that the integrity of the data is intact. Am I clear? Yes or no? We are not talking about user authentication. We are talking about message authentication. Both are totally different things. If I talk about user authentication, then encryption will come into picture. Yes or no? Yes, come on. Let me know the answer. If I'm talking about user authentication, then encryption will come into picture. Yes, A division. Yes, was that correct? Fine, correct B, Harsh. Okay. But now we are talking about message authentication. So we are not finding out कि मैसेज किसने भेजा, वो ऑलरेडी टोटली डिफरेंट थिंग है. मैसेज किसने भेजा मतलब वो यूजर ऑथेंटिकेशन में कवर हो गया, बट क्या मैसेज भेजा दैट कम्स अंडर मैसेज ऑथेंटिकेशन. एम आई क्लियर? दैट द मैसेज इज जेन्युइन और नॉट, मैसेज इज एग्जैक्टली द सेम मैसेज और नॉट, दैट वी कैन मेक श्योर विद द हेल्प ऑफ हैशिंग. फाइन, दैट इज वॉट वी कॉल एज मैसेज मैसेज ऑथेंटिकेशन. क्लियर? ओके. What exactly we do? Let's study in the next slide. Let's consider the scenario. Over here, what we are doing is there are two intended parties of this communication process, Alice and Bob, our favorite characters. So Alice computes a hash value as a function. So पहले scenario को देखो क्या हो रहा है. Alice has some data and Alice wants to send this data to Bob. Now Bob has to check वेदर जो डेटा एलिस ने भेजा है और जो डेटा उसको एक्चुअली मिला है दोनों सेम है या नहीं. यस और नो? कैन एनीवन एक्सप्लेन मी व्हाट एग्जैक्टली इज हैपनिंग? आई हैव ऑलरेडी रिटन इट ओवर देयर, जस्ट रीड इट एंड लेट मी नो इन अ क्विक जिस्ट और अ समरी व्हाट एग्जैक्टली इज हैपनिंग. एलिस इज सेंडिंग सम डेटा, बॉब इज रिसीविंग द डेटा एंड सम कंपैरिजन इज हैपनिंग. What is that comparison happening over here? Come on, students, be active. What exactly is happening? That is what I'm asking. Yes, Harsh, Parth, Rishabh, kindly let me know the answer. Yes, hash value is being compared. Fine. So what will happen if I come to know that the hash value is different? दोनों के हैश वैल्यू में मिसमैच हुआ तो इसका मीनिंग क्या होगा? यस ईशा, जय, ऋषभ, लेट मी नो द आंसर्स. रॉन्ग मैसेज या करेक्ट? हर्ष, रॉन्ग मैसेज या करेक्ट? श्रद्धा, मैसेज इज टैम्पर्ड, मैसेज इज चेंज. यस, वेरी गुड आंसर्स. जय, मैसेज ऑल्टर, करेक्ट. तो जस्ट लुक एट द सिनेरियो वंस अगेन. एलिस इज क्रिएटिंग अ डेटा. एलिस इज फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल क्रिएटिंग द हैश ऑफ द डेटा ऑल्सो एंड एलिस इज अपेंडिंग द डेटा एंड द हैश टुगेदर. अपेंड कर रहे हैं बस मैसेज के बाद में हैश को अटैच करके भेज दिया. दिस इज वॉट वी कॉल एज सॉल्टिंग. इज इट क्लियर? सॉल्टिंग मुझे किसने पूछा था बीच में, आई एम सॉरी आई डोंट रिकलेक्ट द नेम. चैट में मुझे पूछा था किसी ने तो. यस, तो व्हाट हैपेंस इज व्हेन वी ऐड द हैश एट द एंड ऑफ द मैसेज, इट कुड बी हैश, इट कुड बी सम रैंडम डेटा. व्हेन वी ऐड इट, यस हर्ष पटेल, करेक्ट. सो व्हेन वी ऐड एनी डेटा एट द एंड ऑफ द एक्चुअल डेटा, दैट इज इट कुड बी हैश, इट कुड बी रैंडम वैल्यूज एंड देन वी सेंड इट टू द रिसीवर, दैट इज व्हाट वी कॉल एज सॉल्टिंग, राइट? सो द एंटायर पैकेट इज व्हाट वी कॉल एज अ सॉल्ट. Over here, what happens is data is used to create the hash. जो भी हैश आया, हैश को अपेंड किया डेटा के साथ, उसको भेजा रिसीवर को. Now, what will the receiver do? What will Bob do? Bob will first of all accept the data. Correct? आगे क्या? Bob will try to compare the. Bob will first of all compute the hash once again. Yes or no? Correct. So Bob will again compute the hash. What else? What else needs to be done? आगे क्या? If you see carefully at the diagram on the left hand side, this is the data part and this is the hash part, right? So what Alice is sending? Alice is sending data along with hash to Bob. Bob will receive this data part. Okay, so now what happens is, if during the communication, if this data is tampered with, so Bob will obviously not receive the actual data. That is why data dash is written over there. But the hash will not be changed. Yes or no? Hash is already sent as an additional parameter, as an additional input. Yes or no? What will happen? Whatever data Bob will receive, Bob will again compute the hash value of that data. And whatever hash value Bob will now find out, he will compare it with this hash value which he had received from Alice. If both of them are same, then Bob will conclude that the message has not been tampered or the message has not been changed. But on the other hand, if the hash values differ, then Bob will conclude that there has been some change or there is any change in the actual data due to the communication process or due to some attack. Am I clear? Yes. Any confusions with this? Yes, Jay, is it clear? Dhruv, is it clear? Kindly let me know. Harsh, now is it clear? Fine, okay. What about Deep, Jyoti, Harsh, Jay Panchal? Kindly let me know. Okay, fine. Bishop, yeah. So, this was the introduction of this section, that is message authentication. Let's move ahead. We still have time. So, let's move ahead with the drawback of this scenario. Can any one of you let me know the drawback of this scenario? Is any attack possible on this? Yes, come on, let me know. Is any attack possible on this? This is the most simplest sort of a scenario I have shown to you. Now you only let me know, because you're studying this subject, so I'm expecting you to answer this. If the hash function is known, attack is possible. Okay. Harsh, try to refine this statement. Which sort of an attack is possible? Your scenario is correct. If the hash function is known, the attack is possible. But try to refine it. Yes, attack is possible. What if someone tampers? Yes, Rishabh, try to refine your statement. That is what I'm saying. You can change the hash value. Okay, fine. But who changes the hash value? No, brute force is not possible over here, Dhruv. It will take ages for the attacker to attack it using brute force. Salo lag jayenge brute force se. Because you don't have a dictionary, sare possible combinations try karne padenge aapko. So what zyada time lagega brute forcing mein? What else? Correct. Man in the middle attack. Yes or no? Man in the middle. Correct, Arvind. Correct, Swarda. Man in the middle attack. Let me show you how. Let's have a look. Alice has sent the data. Alice ne bheja data ko. But somehow, if Dart is nothing but, yes, Jyoti, correct. Medium he had kar liya. So medium is nothing but the communication medium. That is what is being done in man in the middle, na? Man in the middle mein koi to hota hai. Medium koi to hack karte hum, right? So Alice and Bob are communicating with each other. Dart is the attacker who comes in between the communication process. What exactly happens is, Dart will come in between the communication process. Somehow, Dart will get to know what exactly Alice is sending to Bob. Now, what is this somehow? This somehow is nothing but some sort of traffic analysis, or we can say some passive monitoring or passive attacks. So basically, attacks are of two types: passive attack and active attack. Okay. For example, if Dart is an attacker and Dart is not revealing himself to both Alice and Bob, and still if the attack is communicated, still if the attack is completed, then it is called as a passive attack. Whereas if Dart comes into the picture actively aake sab communication chalu karta hai, Alice ko message bhejta hai, Bob ko message bhejta hai, then it is what we call as an active attack. Am I clear? So over here what happens is, Dart is monitoring the communication process passively. Sare communication ko wo process karta hai, sare traffic ko read karta hai, and somehow he gets access to the data as well as the hash values. Am I clear this time? Yes or no? Somehow, if the Dart gets access to the data and the hash, what he or she will do is, क्या करेगा वो? Data को ही change कर देगा. Yes or no? So, for example, if Alice had sent a message, Alice has transferred 100 rupees to Bob. Just an example, 100 rupees to Bob. Bob, what Dart will do is, Dart will come into the communication and do some changes. Instead of 100 rupees to Bob, what Dart will do with this data, data ko hi tamper kar dega. What he will do is, he will change 100 to 1000, and instead of 100,000 to Bob, it will be changed to 1000 to Dart. Am I making some sense over here? Yes or no? This is basically a man in the middle attack, where Dart is coming in between, changing the contents of the packet. Over here, changing the contents is nothing but changing the actual data. Data ko hi maine change kar diya. Aur jo naya data mila, uska I will create a hash. Is it clear? Yes or no? I came in between, I changed the actual data over here. Actual data ko hi maine change kar diya, uda diya is data ko. Uski jagah naya data bheja. This is the new data which I have created. Instead of 100 to Bob, I have changed it to 1000 to Dart. Am I clear? Fine. So abhi naya data ye hai. Uska hash bhi obviously correspond karega data ko. And now this new data will be sent to Bob. Am I clear? Yes or no? So whatever message Bob will receive, Bob will again compute the hash of it. And this time there won't be any change. So what will happen? Now Bob will receive this message, transfer 1000 rupees to Dart instead of the original message, which was actually like this, that Alice wanted to send 100 rupees to Bob. Now the communication meaning has totally changed. Now Dart came into picture, came in between and asked Bob to send 1000 rupees to him. And obviously there won't be any more changes. So the hash values are going to be equal only. Am I clear? Is this scenario clear? Kindly let me know. Yes. What about others? Fine. Okay. Thank you so much. So in this lecture, I will move ahead with the next topic, because the next topic is all about how to make sure that such an attack doesn't take place. ऐसा अटैक को कैसे रोकेंगे? Obviously, we are going to learn that, but it's a lengthier topic and we can't complete in 7 minutes, obviously, 6 minutes to be precise. So I will stop the lecture here. I will share the attendance link. In the next lecture, we will be resuming this topic and we will see how to protect the hash values from attacks. Fine. If you are having any doubts, you can let me know. And one more announcement: tomorrow, CSS lecture will be again from 1 to 2. Yeah, actually we have a meeting to attend, so I won't be available in the entire morning session. So from 1 to 2, you will be having your CSS lecture. And in the morning, I guess I had lecture from 9:30, right? So it will be your SPCC lecture. I'll put up a message. Just wanted to inform you. Fine? Is it clear? So again, CSS will be from 1 to 2 tomorrow. Okay, so thank you so much. Can we end the session? Do let me know. Yeah. How does Dart become a middleman and connect to the middle? Harsh, that is what I'm saying, that you have to come in between the communication. That can be done with the help of traffic analysis. That is, aap communication ko pehle acche se read karoge. Because ethical hacking ka very first step is all about reconnaissance of the network, or we can say traffic analysis or traffic monitoring. Wireshark use kiya aap logon ne? Nahi to fir hum log karenge, don't worry. If you wahi cheez hai basically. Aap Alice को बोलोगे कि मैं बॉब हूँ, Alice will send the message to you. It is like session hijacking sort of thing. IP spoofing you can say. Session spoofing. So basically, correct answer दिया ज्योति ने. Basically, Dart will communicate with Alice and claim that मैं बॉब हूँ, Alice will send the message to Dart, thinking कि वो बॉब है. समझा? Is it clear? Yes or no? So basically, this is, ये आगे आने वाला है, तो मैंने अभी focus नहीं किया. It is basically impersonation. You are trying to act as somebody else. Clear now? Fine? Okay. We are going to learn all these attacks in module number 5. So I'm going to focus on that module later on. You just overview there on it. Yeah. Okay. So if you are not having any more doubts, let me put up the attendance link.